diwas, salido may diwas.
A journey through Philippine music history. Himig is the Filipino word for melody or intonation, and lakbay means travel or journey. I think we learn best through experience. So rather than providing you with a lecture on Philippine music, we bring you this educational concert. For your guidance, we have provided the song lyrics with their rough translation, should you need them. So it's like going to an opera performed in a language you don't understand or are still learning. There is no better travel guide than this very dynamic and beloved vocal quartet, Perfect Fourth. Perfect Fourth began as an ensemble of four singers representing the voices of a full choir, singing a cappella and performing for recitals and intimate concerts around Manila. The group has performed thrice for the Mads et al. Choral Festival presented by the internationally known Philippine Madrigal Singers in such venues as the Cultural Center of the Philippines and the National Museum. Their repertoire is mainly composed of well-loved American standards, Broadway music, popular love songs, and liturgical and sacred music. Perfect Fourth blends heart to its craft with its gentle but resonant power of four. Its members are Maria Rina Cruz, soprano, Leslie Gabe, alto, Oliver Y. Rojas, tenor, and its music director, arranger, and bass is Paolo Pardo. Joining them this evening is our dear friend, Maestro Edwin Castillo, with over 30 years of experience as a musical director, composer, arranger, choral conductor, pianist, and violinist. He brings with him a wealth of knowledge on Philippine music, and we are so honored that he could join us today. Mga kaibigan, here is Perfect Four with Maestro Edwin Castillo.
Thank you.
Pasneng akmang itongo, tomay diwas, kayo mapiko-piko, tomay diwas. Ay, salidumay diwas. Ay, salidumay diwas. Ay, salidumay diwas. Ay, salidumay diwas. Lali lalai, lali lalai, lali lalai, domay diwas, domay diwas, domay diwas, domay diwas. Ay, salidumay, salidumay diwas. Ay, salidumay, salidumay diwas. Salidumay diwas, salidumay diwas.
What you just heard was an ethnic suite music in pre-contact Philippines. It began with Paolo playing the saronai or baby kulintang, gongs in a row on a wooden trough resonator. The music he played, called Sirung and Tidtu, belongs to the Manggindanawan ethnolinguistic group. Playing the kulintang is an important activity in traditional Maguindanao and Maranao weddings. Gong music is heard continuously throughout the wedding celebration, and weddings become venues for musical competitions. The then Perfect Fourth performed Salidumay, a popular song using words that have no literal meaning, followed by a two-line message from any kind of poem, story, actual event, or of humorous or serious political and social nature. The ethnolinguistic groups of the Northern Luzon Highlands, called the Cordillera, have various versions of this song. Between 1521 and circa 1898, the Philippines was under Spanish colonial rule. This had a strong impact on the local harana, or lovers' serenades, done under the cover of night. Women look out from the balcony, such as the one you saw at the Museo de la Salle, while the admirer, or someone he hires, performs a song accompanied by a guitar. Spanish influence came in the form of the condiman, a song of love for one's nation or affection for a person, often unrequited. So broken-hearted sila. Oliver and Paolo, let us listen to two condiman, one classic, the other modern, rendered for us by Rina, Oliver, and Paolo. Here is Pakiusap, meaning plea, by Francisco Santiago and poet Jose Corazon de Jesus, and Lagi Kitang Naaalala, I Always Remember You, by Leopoldo Silos Sr. and Levi Silerio, National Artist for Music and Literature.
Ang nagpapalam. sulot ng bighati, lalong di mapawi. Langitan na lala, kahit na pilitin kong limutin ka, sa aking puso ay nakalarawan pag-ibig mo lamang. Lagi kitang naalala, kahit na piliin kong limutin ka, sa aking puso ay nakalarawan pag-ibig mo hirang.
Circa 1901 to 1946 was the formal American colonial period. Back then, music was taught primarily in public schools and aired on public radio. The jazz and big band era broke through, making Filipinos kick their feet and dance to swinging music. Here is a sample from that era, the 1932 hit, It Don't Mean a Thing If It Ain't Got That Swing, by Sir Duke Ellington and Irving Wills.
What good is music if it ain't possessing something sweet? It ain't the melody, it ain't the music. There's something else that makes the tune complete. Because it don't mean a thing if it ain't got that swing. Do up, 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 do up. It don't mean a thing, all you've got to do is sing. Do-wop, 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 do-wop. It makes no difference if it's sweet or hot. If it's sweet or hot, just hit the rhythm, everything you got, all you got. Because it don't mean a thing if it ain't got that swing. Do-wop, 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 do-wop.
Better do 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 do
do do do do. It makes no difference if it's sweet or hot. If it's sweet or hot, just give that rhythm everything you've got, all you've got. If it don't mean a thing,
swing.
Do-wop, 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 do-wop.
So while we're at it, here is a song that demonstrates American influence on Filipino songwriting. Because English was widely taught, Filipino composers began writing songs in this language. Here is Jose Marie Chan's Can We Just Stop and Talk a While? This garnered first place at the Tokyo World Popular Music Festival in 1973. Second World War, there was a dawning of nationalism and an emergence of folk and regional songs in various Philippine languages. Scholars in the 1940s conducted meticulous research around the Philippine Islands in search of what was truly Filipino in spirit and in language. Here is a medley of Tagalog folk children's song, Sampung Mga Daliri, Ten Fingers, Penpen de Sarapen, and Telebong. And the song, Usahay, or Sometimes. Usahay, originally written in Cebuano, was for many years wrongly attributed to Nitoy Gonzalez of Cebu. in recent years, due to a court case, the song has been properly attributed to its rightful composer, Gregorio Labha of Davao. You will hear the version in Cebuano with a translation in Filipino by the poet Pia Arboleda.
Sampung mga daliri, kamay at paa, dalawang mata, dalawang tenga, ilong na maganda. Sampung mga daliri, kamay at paa, dalawang mata, dalawang tenga, ilong na maganda. Sampung mga daliri, kamay at paa, dalawang mata, dalawang tenga, ilong na maganda. Sampung mga daliri, kamay at paa, dalawang mata, dalawang tenga, ilong na maganda. Tum 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 tum. Pen pen de sara pen de cuchillo de almacén. How how de carabao batuten. Sipit na mimilipit, gintong pilak na mumulak. Sa tabi ng dagat,
sayang pula tatlong pera.
Ay,
sayang puti tatlong salapi.
Susipit na bibilipit, gintong pilak na mumulaklak sa tabi ng dagat.
Tara,
telebong, telebong, telebong. Si Tembong nagsabong, nanalo ng piso, sumakay pa sa auto.
Ang auto'y bahilang
bilat,
so pero pa'y nabangga sa pader, nalagas ang ipin. Telebong,
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 telebong, telebong, telebong, telebong. Si Tembong nagsabong, nanalo ng piso, sumakay pa sa auto.
Sampung mga daliri. Pen, 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 Tembong! Naginip kita, laging pangarap
bakit sinilang pa sa mundong ito? Bakit tinuya mo lamang pag-iro ko sa'yo at sa'yo? Pag-irog sa'yo lamang usay.
Maraming salamat po. Original Filipino music was a conscious effort in the 1970s and the 1980s to resist colonial influence on Philippine culture during the Marcos regime. As such, there was a proclamation to air a Filipino song every hour to counter the predominance of American music on the airwaves at that time. Although only one song was allowed every hour, it's a very minimal protest. Protest music was also sung in the streets to oppose political oppression under martial law. Here are Panalangin, My Prayer or Fervent Wish by Jim Paredes of the Apo Hiking Society, and Limang Lipang Tao, literally Five Arms Length of People, by national artist for music, Ryan Kayabyab. Originally a cappella, this rendition is arranged by Paolo Pardo.
tungkol sa'yo. Tinatanaw ang pag-akay mo sa babaeng pinagsisilosan ko. Sa pagmamadali na tapa ko sa bangketa kinatatayuan nyo. Lumapit ka at tinulungan ako at kitong tinitigan. Pagmamatay ng kabanggaan, ano ba itong nararamdaman?
On a jeepney, she thought she saw her husband with someone else, and when she tripped, he helped her up, and she looked up, it wasn't the husband. And now she's like without a jeepney. It's horrible. At this point, before they sing their final song, we would like to acknowledge the presence of Maestro Edwin Castillo's mother. Maraming salamat po for the gift of Kuya Edwin. We owe, the world owes you a debt of gratitude. I mean it. We love this guy. For their final song, as the Philippines and the Filipino people go through history, there is an unmistakable constancy of struggle and resistance in our lives. But what is also apparent is that we all long for peace, but it must be a peace based on justice. Please join Perfect Fourth as they express their fervent desire to see a nation without political borders and an abundance of solidarity, harmony through music. You will cry. Here is Isang Dugo, Isang Lahi, literally One Blood, One People by Doji Simon. In closing, naway naibigan ninyo ng lubos ang ating paglalakbay himig. Hanggang sa muli, we hope you enjoyed this show.
Isang
pag-ibig ang hatid. Ang musika'y batid sa bawat puso at isip.
Ikaw at ako, tayo ay Pilipino. Isang bansa, ba't di magkaisa?
Sa bawat puso at isip, isang awit ang aking dalangin. Kristiyano at Muslim, magkaisa sa awitin. Ikaw at ako, tayo ay Pilipino. Isang bansa,
I don't make me feel this way.
My girl,
my girl, my girl,
talking about
love. My girl,
doobie doobie doobie
doobie doobie doobie doobie wop. My girl.
Talking about
my girl.